lived a life of hardship and toil, folk of the Mersey Valley soil, where luxuries of life were few. They relied on the land to make do. Young men our country was needing, the lads went to war unheeding. The dangers to limb and life in our nation's hour of strife. Then a young Tasmanian male joined the corvette Armidale, just a dutiful mother's son, assigned to an Oerlikan gun. Torpedoed and going down fast, the young boy turned back to his task. The ship reduced to a burning wreck, here came the boy of the lower deck. He scrambled on hands and knees, shot and wounded on a bloodied sea. He strapped himself to his Oerlikan gun, defied the land of the rising sun. At just 18, an ordinary seaman, it seemed like he unleashed a demon like few had encountered before. He was prepared to even the score, attacking with murderous intent, strafing weak and dying men. He took aim at the plains of his foe, till he was claimed by the depths below. And as a bugle reminds us yet, well might we remember the death of the valiant in pelagic graves, owed bravery beneath the waves. What more could our country ask when giving one's life in the task he so unselfishly gave in exchange for that of his mates? Such heroics must remain in our mind, lest we forget our one of a kind. Not a medal for such bravery yet, he was just a boy of the lower deck. Should not a VC be bestowed for Teddy Sheehan, the boy from Latrobe?